Mike Moore Media.
Thank you for joining us today. My name is Lydia Craddock, and I'm employed with the Rockingham County School Systems. I do what I love, and I love what I do. And part of what I do with the system is to hook students up with occupations, with people who hired them in their career interest. Our focus is making sure that students can be matched to the career that they are wanting to pursue. So recently I was in a business meeting, and business leaders were talking about the need for employees, how many employees we are needing. And they were talking about how can we access our teenagers? How can we get our teenagers employed? So I was all prepared to come in here today and talk about the good things, the positive things about why teenagers should be working. Things like their grades often improve. Things like they learn time management skills. They learn money management skills. They can do a lot of career exploration. I had done all my research, and I was going to talk to you about that. Then all of a sudden, I was invited into an advisory committee meeting at one of the high schools, and I was blown away to find out students that are already doing this. So that's what I decided to share with you today. I was at Moorhead High School, and I was in an advisory committee meeting for their auto mechanics program. Now, the auto mechanics program is offered both at Moorhead High School and at Rockingham County High School. They work very closely together. But this advisory committee is not just made up of instructors or dealership owners. It is made up of students that have graduated from the program, and it is made up of students that are also in the program. Their desire is to bring our community the strongest automotives program they can so that we can provide automotive technicians in our community. We know we need them. But I was absolutely blown away by the success stories that I found there. Now, I have permission to talk with you about each of these folks. I never get online and or on air and talk about folks that I don't have permission to talk about. But I want to tell you about Kevin. Kevin is he is a high school student that already has his own entrepreneurial business. Now, his business doesn't have anything to do with automotives, but he is taking the automotives technology class. And then I overhear a conversation that he's having with his instructor. His instructor is talking to him about, we're going to work together with your entrepreneurial spirit and with what you are learning in Autotech so that as you go out of high school, you have a career that you're excited about and that will pay your bills. And this student, by the way, is already in his business, is helping carry the financial load for his family. Exciting news to hear. And by the way, each of our high schools does offer classes in entrepreneurship for our students. We are seeing in our current economy the importance of entrepreneurship, and our economic department, Department of Economic Development at Rockingham County over there in Wentworth has some great classes that are available to folks that are looking into opening their own businesses. But that's a success story for Kevin. We're going to follow him through high school, and we're going to see what happens when he graduates. But I want to tell you about Jared. Now, Jared followed a career and technical education pathway in high school. Career and technical education, if you've listened to our podcast before, is the word that grandmother used to say, vocational courses. But these are courses where students not only learn the academics of something, they also learn the trade portion of it, where they are touching and making and doing. So Nick was in the Jared. Jared was in the automotives program. He did this in his 10th and 11th grade year. And then in his 12th grade year, he talks with his career development coordinator and says he wants to do an internship. That means for an hour and a half every day during the school day, he's out in the community working in an area that touches his career. So he gets she helps him find an internship with a dealership where he is for one semester, he's working in their parts department. Another semester, he's working in their service department. That's during his senior year. And doing that career exploration while he has already had his his automotive tech courses, allows him to realize that, yes, this is the field I want to work in. that company actually hired Jared after he graduated from high school. So he actually began to do service, oil changes, things of that nature. He's been working there, and they like his work well enough that they've said to him, we will now help you with additional education, additional certifications. If you're familiar with the automotive industry, you get certified in a number of different areas so that you can work on all the various components of those vehicles. So they're so excited with him that they are willing to take on the burden of paying for his education. That's how career and technical education pathways work in our high schools. What happens is students explore interest, students take classes, students can then do internships to continue to explore that career, and then we work with them to try to help them get that either an employment position or the education that they need to continue. So excited and wishing Jared actually the very, very best. But then both of those examples came from Morehead. Then I turn around and there's a young man there and his story. Nick is, he completed his automotive program at Rockingham County High School, but he also took dual enrollment classes at RCC for welding. Now, dual enrollment means that our community college, Rockingham Community College, works with our school system and they offer classes that the student can get college credit and credentials for at the same time that they are getting high school credentials or credit for. The great thing about that is that the student doesn't have to pay college tuition while they are doing this dual enrollment in high school. So exciting things. It seems like such an easy thing to do, but RCC and RCS work very hard. There's a lot of pieces behind the scenes that have to be managed in terms of schedules and in terms of matching credentials, things of that nature. So we're so happy, we're excited that RCC brings that service, that dual enrollment to our students. But let's go back to Nick. So Nick completed his welding certifications. He had also been doing his automotive technology at Rockingham County High School. He was doing his welding certifications at Rockingham Community College. Upon graduation, he was offered a position that was going to pay him $20 an hour. Now, don't gasp when you hear this. He turned that down. He turned down $20 an hour upon graduating from high school because somewhere he had gotten in his mind the importance of, and we're so thankful, the importance of education for the long haul rather than money for the present day. So Nick accepted a position with the Rockatop Apprenticeship Program where he is continuing his education. At RCC, he is working on an associate's degree while he is employed by a company that is providing him on-the-job training. So no, he's not making $20 an hour, but he's getting a good wage, but he is getting a wage, and he is also having his education paid for through the apprenticeship program and the state of North Carolina. So excited to hear and see what the future holds for Nick. I think he will be finishing that associate's degree next year. He's just been phenomenal in the program, and the fact that he could see as a teenager the value of, instead of going just for the money present day, I need to go for the long haul. Folks, we have some students in our school system that are really stepping up to the plate. And when you hear people talking about our teenagers this, our teenagers that, I want you to remember these stories that I'm sharing with you about our teenagers are stepping up to the plate. With the help of their CTE teachers, their academic teachers, with the help of their school counselors, with the help of their career coaches, all of these folks are working together to make sure these students can connect with a career. So that's present day. And that was what I saw at the meeting that I was in the other day. And as I said, I have their permission to tell you this. But I was at a job fair. Just as a matter of fact, I think it was day before yesterday, at a job fair day before yesterday, connected with a young lady, and it turns out that this young lady, she graduated from Rockingham County High School 11 years ago with her CNA, her Certified Nursing Assistant. We offer that program at every single one of our high schools. Now, I remember when she took that job because 2 weeks after she took that job, she called me. I was her personal finance teacher, and she called me and she said they were going to pay me $10 an hour, but I don't have that much money in my check. And I said, okay, let's think about this. Let's think about this FICA taxes. Let's think about state taxes. We went back through why she didn't have that much money in her check. I'll never forget that conversation. But the reason I'm sharing that with you is that 11 years later, this young lady is the residential care director for this assisted living facility. The way she got herself into that door, developed that career, is because of the career and technical education training that she received in her high school. So excited. We have teenagers that are stepping up to the plate. Let me give you one other example. This time on our podcast goes so quickly. But last night, and again, day before yesterday, I saw this student. This student went away to UNC Wilmington, I think. They got a degree in recreational therapy. They came back to Rockingham County and are now serving our population of special needs adults in a role as an assistant, as a director for a day program for our special needs adults. Fantastic to see. We have students that we provide the education they need to get that career started. They then do the training that they need to go further in that career, and then they come back to Rockingham County and they serve our citizens here. Guys, we have so many students that are willing to step up to the plate like this. Our Rock-A-Top program, it works to connect students with apprenticeships. It works to connect students with credentials. It works to connect the student that wants to go directly from high school into a full-time permanent career job. It works to also connect students with summer work so that they can explore careers. If you have a student or know a high school student in our school system, please tell them to reach out to their school counselors or their career development coordinator to talk more about how courses in high school can help them reach their career goals. We have a certain set of courses that are absolutely required by the state of North Carolina, and then students do have a lot of choice in the electives they pursue. We have a team at each high school that will help them pursue electives that help them with their career. One other thing I want to tell you that Rockingham County Schools is doing, we are going into the 7th and 8th grades talking with students about what is your career interest so that as they enter high school in the 9th grade, they can, if it is appropriate for them, they can be like a student like Jared, who got on the right track from day one and then was able to graduate into a program, into a career, and into somewhere that actually helped pay for his education after high school. Folks, we're doing tremendous things, but we can't do tremendous things without students that are dedicated to it. And so it's all because of our students that are wanting to do tremendous things, and it's because of parents that are supporting them to do tremendous things, and then, of course, our industries out in the community. If you would like more information about any of the programs that I've chatted about, if you're industry and you want us to get information out to our students about careers you offer, if you are parents and you want to talk to someone about the trainings that we offer, if you are a student and you want to be hooked up with someone at your school that can help you pursue your career passions, please contact me at Rock-A-Top, just like it sounds, Rock-A-Top, R-O-C-K-A-T-O-P, rockatopnc@gmail.com. We'd love to talk to you, get you directed to someone who can help you. We're excited to see our students in Rockingham County really stepping up to the plate in our workforce here in Rockingham County. Thank you so much for listening to us today. Don't forget to get in touch with us. My name is Lydia, but you can contact me at rockatopnc@gmail.com. Thank you so much.